Good morning everyone, welcome to your English class. Today we are going to do the explanation of lesson number 3, homesickness. And as you know that this is my third video of this lesson, that's why I have written part 3 over here. Now we will do the explanation from page number 23. Open your books on page number 23. Para number 28. He said, it reads normally. Let me feel your stomach once more. 29. Para. Ouch, I screamed when he touched the vital spot. The doctor went away with the matron. Like the matron, he must have felt it safer to send me home rather than risk an appendicitis operation in the school. The matron returned half an hour later and said, the headmaster has telephoned your mother and she's coming to fetch you this afternoon. Dear students, as we have already discussed in our previous videos that the speaker was pretending to be sick and he wanted to go home because he was actually homesick. He was pretending that as if he is getting appendicitis problem, but when the doctor came and checked him, what he found? He found that he was normal. His stomach seemed to be normal, but when he touched the vital spot, again the speaker started screaming and making noise like ouch. He spoke ouch. He screamed. The doctor went away with the matron and. Like the matron, he must have felt it. The speaker is thinking, in para number 30, the speaker is thinking that just like the matron thought that it would be better to send the speaker home instead of getting appendicitis removed in the school. He thought that doctor has also gone because he must be thinking the same thing. The headmaster has telephoned your mother and she is coming to fetch you this afternoon. Who said this? The matron came back in half an hour and he told the speaker that the headmaster has called his mother and she is coming to take him home. I didn't answer her. I just lay there trying to look very ill. But my heart was singing out with all sorts of wonderful songs of praise and joy. Now what is being told in para number 31? In para number 31, the speaker is telling us that when he came to know that his mother is coming to take him home, he was very happy. He was singing the songs of joy and praise. But he was pretending that he is very ill. He played still as if he is very ill. Para number 32. I was taken home across the Bristol Channel and I felt so wonderful at being away from the school that I very nearly forgot I was meant to be ill. That afternoon, I had a session with Dr. Dunbar in Cardiff and I tried the same trick all over again. But Dr. Dunbar was far wiser and more skillful than either the matron or the school doctor. Now what is being told here in para number 32? Para number 32 tells us that he was taken home across the Bristol Channel. And Bristol Channel means, and I felt so wonderful at being away from the school that I very nearly forgot I was meant to be ill. Here the speaker is telling us that he didn't actually reach home, but he was so excited that in his mind he forgot all about being ill, and that afternoon he had a session with Dr. Dunbar in Cardiff and he tried the same trick all over again, but Dr. Dunbar was far more wiser and more skillful than matron. Para number 33. After he had prodded my stomach and I had done my yelping routine, he said to me, now you can get dressed again. and seat yourself on that chair. Now what is being told here? The speaker is telling us that when he finished his session with the doctor, he came to know. The doctor told him that now he can sit on the chair and get his himself dressed again. He himself sat down behind. He himself sat down behind his desk and fixed me with a penetrating but not unkindly eye. "You're faking, aren't you?" he said. "How do you know?" I blurted out. "Because your stomach is soft and perfectly normal," he answered. "If you had had an inflation down there, the stomach would have been hard and rigid." "It's quite easy to tell," I kept silent. "I expect you're homesick," he said. I nodded miserably. Now what is being told in, from para number 34 to para number 39? From para number 34 to para number 39, there's a conversation going on between the doctor and the speaker. When the doctor asked him to sit on the chair, he fixed him with a penetrating. Penetrating means steady and sharp, as if looking into the other's mind. He gave a sharp look at the speaker, but he was not being unkind through his eyes. He was not having an unkind look over him. He asked him that, isn't he faking about being sick? The speaker blurted out that yes, he was. And he asked him the question, how does he know? The doctor told him that because his stomach was perfectly soft and normal. He also answered that if there would have been any inflation on the in the stomach, it would have been rigid and hard. The doctor also exclaimed that he must be homesick. Listening to this, the speaker miserably nodded his head. Para number 40. "Everyone is at first," he said. "You have to stick it out and don't blame your mother for sending you away to boarding school. She insisted you were too young to go, but it was I who persuaded her. It was the right thing to do. Life is tough, and the sooner you learn how to cope with it, the better for you." Now para number 40. In para number 40, the doctor told the speaker that everyone feels homesick at first when he or she goes to school, but he also tells him that he shouldn't blame his mother for that, because it was Dr. Dunbar who forced her to send him to school, because according to Dr. Dunbar, it was the perfect timing to send him to school. He also suggests him that life is tough and it will be better the sooner he learns to cope up with the life, and the better it would be for him. Now turn the page to page number 24. "What will you tell the school?" I asked him, trembling. 42, para number. "I'll say you had a very severe infection of the stomach, which I am curing with pills," he answered, smiling. "It will mean that you must stay home for 3 more days. But promise me you won't try anything like this again. Your mother has enough on her hands without having to rush over to fetch you out of school." "I promise," I said, "I'll never do it again." Dear students, in para number 42, the doctor tells him that he will not tell the school committee that he was faking about being sick. Instead of that, he told him that he will tell the school that he had a severe infection in his stomach, and which he was curing with the pills. He also told him that he has to promise him that he will not make any kind of act again. He also the speaker promised the doctor that he will never do it again. Dear students, this is an excerpt from Boy Tales of Childhood by Roald Dahl. That's all for today, dear students. I hope you all have understood the lesson nicely. Thank you and have a good day.